Hey y'all, what's up? Welcome back to an interesting video. I'm your boy Jay Bird, aka Mr. Cool Guy. With today's video, I'm reviewing Jay-Z's second album that came out when it was the year 1997, called Volume 1, In My Lifetime. And I gotta say, this album is such a classic, and I know he dedicated this album to fellow Brooklyn rapper Notorious B.I.G., who was assassinated when it was the year 1997 around March. And I gotta say, this album did debut at number 3 on the charts, and it was certified platinum, and it sold like over 138,000 copies in the first week, and it's got about like 3 singles on the album, such as Always Be My Sunshine, The City Is Mine, Wishing On A Star, and it's about 14 tracks on this album. We're gonna get into like all 14 tracks on this second album by Jay-Z, starting with track 1, intro, 1,000,001 Questions / Rhyme No More. Here we go, y'all.
I've been here before. Seems like only yesterday when I got up on that stage in front of that crowd and showed them who was who and what was what. Man, look at these suckers. I ain't no rapper. I'm a hustler. Just so happens I know how to rap. Okay, I'm reloaded!
Did it again, nigga. Fucked up, right? I know what y'all niggas asking y'all, so. You gonna ever fall off? No. A lot of speculation on the monies I've made. Honeys I've slayed. How is he for real? Is that nigga really paid? Hustlers I've met or dealt with direct. Is it true he stayed in beef and slept with a tech? What's the position you hold? Can you really match a triple platinum artist buck by buck, but only a single going gold? Rockefeller shit roll, and you left out in the cold. Sit back and charge your motherfuckers 11 for a hoe. For the millionth time, asking me questions like Wendy Williams harassing me. They get upset when I catch feelings. Can I get a minute to breathe? And in that minute you leave, while I'm looking at my roll, ice spinning on my sleeve. Nice watch. Do you really have a spot? Like you said, a friend of foe, and if so, what block? What you doing in LA with Filipinos and essays? Latinos and Chevys down by Pico with Federico. I answer all y'all questions, but then y'all got to go. Now the question I ask you is how bad you wanna go. Black! Motherfuckers can't rhyme no more, about crime no more, time no more. Cause I'm so raw, my flow exposed holes that they find in yours. Wasn't for me, niggas still be dying for whores. But I hate when a nigga sit back, admiring yours. Young blood, you better get that, we rhyme McCall.
Now, I gotta say track 1, intro, / 1,000,001 Questions / Rhyme No More. It's good that DJ Primo produced that track and helped co-written it with Jigga. And you all can tell me like, when y'all think of that track, is that one of the dopest intro / songs to begin the record with? Please share, because I think Jay-Z did his thing with working with DJ Primo on that track, and it's dope. And y'all can tell me like what y'all like about it in the comments below. All right, moving on, track 2, The City Is Mine featuring Blackstreet. Here we go, y'all.
Yeah.
still play boys, just rest your soul. I be holding it down, yo, still love it though. Got these ladies on the cop now, you know how we go. Got the whole world on lockdown, you know how we flow. Don't worry about women, I can tell you the plan. The whole world with amnesia won't forget your name. You know the down long enough, let me take those hands. And just like the spirit of commission on fans, niggas cross the T's and dot the I's. Now that I got too popular, the cops advise. I'm taking this rap shit serious. Till my demise, Jay shit's like K-Nick. Watch me rise, basics in the basement. Wait this, asking my dog for advice. And when he can't say shit, my hatred is you. Just give me a sign. And I let the world know that the city is mine. Walk. The voice box, I speak my mind. About to redefine rap, mommy. Either I'm the illest nigga doing it, or these niggas are losing it. I read an article that said I was growing and shit. But every time I look, I move a unison quick. So I'ma hit y'all with these last two and spin. To leave niggas with nothing but my influence. As soon as the jigger, I ain't mad yet. Bite my shit. So half of what I sell, cause it's not quite my shit. I'm the type to buy a movie and just ice my shit. On the spot, fuck, coming back twice the shit. I'm real as that. But floor's game, still intact. Boss game, you name dudes can't feel that. Like the first dude who copped the 850 and 89 and drove it up to 55th. City is mine. Fuck.
Now I gotta say, track two, "The City Is Mine" featuring Blackstreet. I really like that joint. It's got like a lot of hardcore hip-hop, R&B, and jazz rap coming together, and Teddy Riley did good with producing that track, and Jigga did good working with these guys, Blackstreet, and I really feel all that East Coast hip-hop and R&B, and they got like that jazz rap as well, and you walk into them like, we got like about that song. That one of the dopest singles off the album, even though it debuted at 52 on the U.S. Billboard Hot 100, and debuted at number 37 for U.S. Hot R&B / Hip Hop song on the Billboard, and 14 for U.S. Hot Rap joint. Alright, moving on. Track 3, "I Know What Girls Like" featuring Puff Daddy and Lil' Kim. Here we go, y'all.
Fuck a pre-dub, give me half up front. My sex be the best, so we spit these cards. You can stop staying mine. start saying no.
I know what girls like.
Now, track three, I Know What Girls Like, featuring Puff Daddy and Lil' Kim. I gotta say, I really feel that song. It's got like a lot of East Coast hip-hop and a little bit of dirty rap and sex talk coming together. And it's good that Jay-Z got to work with Lil' Kim and Puff Daddy on this song. And I know the song is pretty much sampled from a classic by this group called Boogie Boys with their song A Fly Girl, and I really feel that beat. And Jigga did go with that track. It's got like a lot of rap pop and samples of rock coming together and East Coast hip hop, and I really feel that bass. And you walk and tell me like what y'all like about track three in the comments below. Is that one of the dopest songs that Jigga did on this album or not? Please share, because I think it is, and it was pretty ill, and I give it that. All right, moving on, track four, Imaginary Player. Here we go, y'all.
I'd be like the pioneers and shit, you know. I was popping that crystal when a lot of y'all niggas thought it was beer and shit. You know? Wearing that platinum shit when all y'all chicks thought it was silver and shit. I wanna be the pioneer in this shit. Bottom line. I'ma show y'all how to do it. Check. Yo, I spit that other shit. That's a nice motherfucker shit. Fat time following me around. Deep cover shit, nigga. You been money. I'm all year money. I'm popping, you ain't got to count it. It's all live money. I never change money, cause niggas got strange money. Knocked up, marked up, fucked up in the game money. I got bail money. Double XL money. You got flash now, but time will reveal money. I spit the hottest shit. You need it, I got it shit. That downside master P. Bout it shit. I got blood money, straight up thug money. That brown paper bag under your mattress, drug money. You got show dough, little to no dough. Sell a bunch of records and you still owe dough. I got 996 plus FOMO dough. You crazy, you fugazi. I'm loco with dough, pop-o. Yeah. I mean, young cats acting like they slum cats, holding they dumb raps, talking about how they fun stacks. When I see them in the street, I don't see none of that. Damn, playboy, the fuck is the hum at? Where's all the ice with all the platinum under that? Those ain't Rolex diamonds, what the fuck you done to that? Y'all rapping ass niggas, y'all funny to me. Selling records being you, but still you wanna be me. I guess for every buck you make, it's like 100 for me. And still you running around thinking you got something on me. But I done did it, and y'all wanna take my flow and run with it. That's cool, I was the first one with it. Original, Jigga's the future flow, digital. Still busting the gap when shit gets critical. Sit it down, I don't want y'all to get it confused. I rip it down, like I ain't got nothing to lose.
Now this song, Imaginary Player, I really feel that joint, and I really like that Jay-Z boasts about his rapping abilities and the progressive lifestyle that he lived, and result of his newfound fame. And I know he sampled a classic joint from 1981 called Imaginary Playmates by Renee and Angelette. And with this song, I don't know if he was dissing Master P and a few other people, but I say the song is pretty dope, and I really feel it. And you all can tell me like what y'all like about that track. Is that one of the dopest songs on this album with a lot of R&B and East Coast rap coming together? Please share. Alright, moving on. Track 5, Streets Watching. Here we go, y'all.
You watching streets. If I shoot you, I'm brainless. But if you shoot me, you're famous. What's a gonna do when the streets is watching? Blast keep clocking, waiting for you to break, to make your first mistake. You can't ignore it. That's the fastest way to get extorted. But my time is money. At 25, I can't afford it. Beef is sorted like a diver. Choppers, as you want it. I pull a slide back and cock it. Plan to board it. You and your mans get a pass. This rhyme, you're operating on. Time. Y'all niggas ain't worth my shells. All y'all niggas tryna do is hurt myself. Stop trips to John McNeil. The track is starting beeping. Running the cops when I see you in the street. Got one in the drop. When I'd rather be on tour getting a 100 a pop. Taking pictures with some. Running the drop. The street is watching. Watch. Watch. Blocks keep rocking. Waiting for you to break. Make your first mistake.
That's
pretty official. And you're hard not to kill me. It's like a full-time job, not to kill me. Can't chill, the streets is watching. When you froze your arms, niggas wanna test you when your gun goes warm. Can't get caught with your feet up, gotta keep your feet up. Sweet niggas running around, swing sweet up. Once you tag lane, the game is follow the leader. Everybody want a piece of your skrilla, so you gotta keep it realer. Kidnap niggas wanna steal you. Broke niggas want no cash, they just wanna kill you. For the name, niggas don't know the rules. Disrespecting the game, want you to blow your cool.
Now, I gotta say, track 5, Streets Watching, I really feel that song. It's got like a lot of rap rock, including East Coast hip hop coming together. Now, I know this song is basically the same type of his 1998 film from the soundtrack from his movie called Streets Watching. And I gotta say, the song, it is dope. It's based about rap stars and drug kingpins. Is that everyone always want to keep an eye out on them. And Jay-Z struggled with being both. And a theme that runs heavily through the song is how frustrating he is at not being able to kill his enemies on the street because his fame. And I say that is a dope track, and it do got like a lot of gangster vibe in here with East Coast hip hop and rap rock. And you walk and tell me like, we all like about track 5, is that one of the dopest songs on the record or not? Please share, because I think it is. All right, moving on, track 6, Friend or Foe, 98. Here we go, y'all. Say track 6, Friend or Foe, 98. I like that DJ Premium produced that track with that old hip hop flow in there coming together with East Coast hip hop and gangster rap. And I know it's a sequel to the first ever song he did called Friend or Foe. That was on his debut album called Reasonable Doubt. And I say this version of the song is dope. And you all can tell me which one y'all think is better, the previous song on his first ever album or this one on his second album. Please share. Alright, moving on. Track 7. Lucky Me. Here we go, y'all.
How can you feel you said something from the outside looking in? Drive you to times you'll be wrong, you know what I mean? I come off from going around and here to make it happy and let it go and let it go. I think this rap shit is okay. Yeah, I don't even know. Everything I'm living with stress. Got about the street, you think a nigga could rest. Can't even enjoy myself at a party unless I'm on the dance floor, high that fast. You think I'm freaking these chicks, right? Try not to brush against the chest. You done lost some for shit like that. I feel trapped, I swear to everything. When I leave this earth, it's gonna be on both feet. Never need to deserve, you can try me, fuck up. But when I squeeze, it hurts, fine. We lose two lives, yours and mine. Give me any amount of time, don't let this car to grieve. At the funeral parlor, dripping tears on my sleeve. Told the judge, didn't budge, it was him on me. And I ain't trying to be hard, but I'm guilty as charged. Put my mercy on this court and my faith in God. And pray hard, none of my nephews, one of these stars, love you big. I'm 20 plus years old, no sons, no daughters. They put my life in the hands of fake promoters. Hear the hate in my voice, right? I hate that you know this. Niggas wanna strip you to the bone for shit you own. Hate a nigga like that, faggot, get your own. Hate that I can't roam the street without the clip and chrome. Knowing one day I'ma have to flip. Come on, you know this shit don't stop. Till the crisp don't pop. You have to kill a nigga and your wrist don't lock. Trap, whole world's against me in back. There ain't no turning back. Really on, hate the price of fame, cause it costs too much. Can I live without your nigga saying I've lost too much? Hate the way you make this hate flow, all through us. Then he looking for flaws to us. Lucky me.
Now I gotta say, track 7, Lucky Me, I really feel that joint, and I really like that story that Jiggle was spitting in this song, and it's very touchy, and I really like all that East Coast hip hop coming together with a little bit of R&B melodies. And you all can tell me like what y'all like about that track. Is that one of the very touchy songs that Jiggle did, or y'all just like that he was spitting some fire with that track, having a female vocalist on that song such as Karen Anderson? And I know Stevie J and Buck Wild is the executive producers of that track and helped co-written it as well. And you all can tell me what y'all like about that track in the comments below, even though Lil Wayne said this was one of his best songs and he credited this album by Jay-Z, one of his best albums during his lifetime, that inspired him to become a rapper when he was in that group Hot Boys. So, alright, moving on. Track 8, Always Be My Sunshine. Here we go, y'all.
One, check off.
Drop me. I said, but surely you're right. Better say than sorry. Before the love birds can move to the suburbs, I need to
check your story to make sure that you're one of a kind and you deserve to be my sunshine.
Sunshine featuring Foxy Brown and Babyface. I gotta say, this song do got like a lot of gangster rap and R&B coming together. And Jigga did good that track. It's a banger joint off the record, and I actually feel it. And it's still a unique classic. Got like a lot of R&B and hip hop coming together. And I know they sample a classic by Alexander O'Neal with his song Sunshine and a few other hits though, but you all can tell me like we got like about track 8. Is that one of the dopest songs on the record or off the record? Please share. Alright, moving on, track 9. Who You With? Part 2. Here we go, y'all.
Yeah, sprung, Jigga, Michael Philly, never sprung, Yeah, in the repertoire, pause, feel me on this one, pause, feel this, never sprung, I love bitches, young bitches, shy bitches, rough bitches. Don't matter, you're my bitches. Gold diggers with your eyes on my riches. Can't knock your hustle for reals, aight bitches. I'm game tight. See it all through the platinum French frames with the French name. And the same night, call you and your tight friend. Lift your little dress like light wind. Then I slide right in. You know the whole repertoire, US to the USSR. Possessing in the Lexus car. Match wits with the best of y'all. The rest of y'all's like match. The balls is my presence checking, reminiscing of nothing you ever heard. Iceberg, slim baby, ride ranch through the suburbs. Funds coming up, some never ends the curve. Get money like I'm down south, Wednesday the 3rd. It's all dough to get, more shows to rip. I suggest you won't roll with the click. Who you with? Frozen wrists, it's flows are sick. More holes than you know what's this, bitch. Who you with? Can't scheme on them. Rockefeller got a team on them. Chicks dream on them, trick cream on them. Loser when dudes think it's just music. Lean on them, flash green on them, and diamond rings on them. Sets around the way girls down to meet eyes. I'm something every girl gotta have like Levi's. You keep the eye, me got more. See, I roll. You can love me or hate me. Eat I all. I'm a stick.
Now, I gotta say, track 9, Who You With, part 2. I really feel that song, and Jigga did good with them rhymes. And I know he sampled a classic song from 1981 called Night Love, and Who You With was recorded for the soundtrack Sprung, the 1997 film starring Tish Campbell from Martin, and I know it was a soundtrack version featured on the movie album of that film Sprung, and I'd say Jay did good with that this track floating over a smooth Skype beat production, and I really feel the flow and the energy that he did was spitting on this song. And you all can tell me like we all like about track 9. Is that one of the dopest songs on the record or not? Please share. Because I think it is, though, with all that smooth R&B come together with East Coast hip hop. Here we go, track 10, Face Off, featuring Sauce Money. Here we go, y'all. Sorry for pronouncing his name wrong.
Sauce motherfucking Jigga, feel it. Go down to my Brooklyn crew. Put your guns up, check your head, hit the field, baby. I'm on the wrong day, on the wrong night. I don't love these souls. Go down to my Brooklyn crew. Put your guns up, check your head, hit the field, baby. I'm on the wrong day, on the wrong night. I don't love these souls. Get your guns up, get your guns up. It's on, make you snow that. When the sun's up, you're gone. Fuck the bitches, go, bitches, go. Fuck, I am vibrating, the niggas know. Fuck, full black cap with the Mac out. I take shorty to the room, go back out.
Say track 10, Face Off, featuring Sauce Money. They were both dope on that track, and I really like that Track Masters produced that track, and they taking it back to old school hip hop with that song. And I really feel all the gangster rap coming together and crunk coming together as well. Jigga and Salt Money, they were cold on this track and actually vibe with it. And you all can tell me like what y'all like about that track. Is that one of the dopest songs on the record or not? Let me know your thoughts, because I think it is. All right, moving on. Track 11, Real Niggas, featuring Too Short. Here we go, y'all.
Bank book. I'm not a crook. I flip the script and change. change my ways before I can get paid. Every day I see the same old shit I see in the street. I know you think I'm selling keys, but I only sell beats. You feel I'm feeling busy. It's drug related. You can buy it on the corner, get a radio and play. It always sounds better when you turn it up loud. Rap music, let these motherfuckers know what we about. I know it's good.
Now, I gotta say, this song, Real Niggas featuring Too Short, I really feel Jigga and Too Short flow on this song and those verses that they were spitting. And I know this is another hard edge track, continues Jay-Z development as a lyricist and storyteller in his earlier career. And the song is also a plow to fans not to know, not to judge him harassly for the wrong he commit on the way to success. And it's important, it's an important track in Jay's back catalog as it is debuted his desire to reach out and collaborate with artists from other areas. Too Short is from Oakland, California, and at that time was collaborating heavily with Southern artists. And I gotta say, that song is pretty dope, and I really feel the storytelling, and Jigga is a lyricist, and I really feel his flow, his energy, and I'm glad that he got to work with other artists from different areas, such as Too Short, even though Too Short is from California, and he's from New York, and it's good that they won getting into the all the East versus West beef at that time, though. But you all can tell me, like, we got like about track 11. Is that one of the dopest songs on the record or not? Please share, because I think it is. And Jigga and Too Short were cold on that track. Well, moving on, track 12, Rap Game / Crack Game. Here we go, y'all. And I know, like, this is when he was beefing with Nas at that time, and I know he sampled some of Nas's voice. I mean, sampled Nas's voice from his previous song called "Represent" from his first ever album called, what was that album called? Dang, I forgot what the album was called. But I know he sampled a song from one of Nas's classics, though. But you all can tell me, like, we all like about that song, and was it one of the best disses that he took towards Nas, even though he was sampling a classic from Nas's album called Illmatic. That's why I meant to say Illmatic. Let me know, like, is that one of the dopest disses that Jay-Z put on this album? Because I don't know what to say, but he did took shots at Nas, and that's how they beef must have started, though. But y'all can just tell me what y'all think of track 12. Moving on. Track 13, Where I'm From. Here we go, y'all.
Check. I'm from the other side where other guys don't walk too much. The girls from the projects wouldn't fuck us and we talk too much. So they ran up the time because they saw them fools to trust. I don't know what the fuck they thought, but niggas is foul just like us. I'm from where the beat is inevitable, summertime's unforgettable. Boosters in abundance, buy a half price sweater new. Your word was everything, so everything you said you'd do, you did it. Couldn't talk about it if you ain't living. I'm from where niggas pull your car and argue all day about who's the best MCs. Biggie, Jay-Z, and Nas, where the drugs are evolved and thugs are at odds. At each other's throats for the love of foreign cars. Catch cases, hoping to judge R&Rs. But most times find themselves locked up behind bars. I'm from where they ball and green rhyme stars. I'm from Marcy, son. Just thought I'd remind y'all. Come from a lung where I'm from. Marcy, son. Ain't got it nice. Many places when I'm Brooklyn's home. Come from a lung where I'm from. Marcy, son. Ain't got it nice. Many places when I'm Brooklyn's home. Yeah. Come from a lung where I'm from. Marcy, son. Ain't got it nice. Many places when I'm Brooklyn's home. Come from a lung where I'm from. Marcy, son. Ain't got it nice.
I gotta say, that song, Where I'm From, I really feel all that gangsta rap and East Coast hip-hop, and Jigga was spinning some fire with that song. I really gotta say, he is a dope lyricist, and I really feel his flow and his energy, and when he spit rhymes like that, it just made me want to listen to his music over and over and over again. And you all can tell me, like, what y'all like about track 13. Is that one of the dopest tracks on the album or not? Please share, because I think the track is fire. Alright, moving on, track 14, final track of the album, You Must Love Me. Here we go, y'all.
Yeah.
to make me tougher as we grew. Fussing and fighting continue as I plundered through your stuff and snuck your clothes to school. Got intense, real intense as we got older. Never believed it would lead to be popping one in your shoulder. With my rings, knew you had it cause you took too long. As Mickey, Annie, and the girl that bought it looked on. Puffing and puffing, gun in my hand, told you step outside. Hoping you said no, but you hurt my pride. Made our way down the steps. Maybe you thought it was just a threat, or maybe your life was just that crazy. You was begging for death. Trying to justify this in my young mind. But the adrenaline and my ego hurt combined. Drove me berserk. Saw the devil in your eyes. High off more than me. Confused. I just closed my young eyes and squeezed. Open the sound. Open my eyes just in time to see you stumbling into the ground. What the fuck I done now? Running around in the circle, thinking I'm assed out. Hot gun burning my waist, ran straight to Jazz House like a stranger. Damn, I just shot my nigga and ran up into the night as if it was not my nigga. Left the scene. How could I go out that way? Still, you asked to see me in the hospital the next day. You must love me.
Now, I gotta say, track 14, You Must Love Me, I really feel the story that Jay-Z was telling in this song, and I really feel all his rapping ability, and he is a dope lyricist, and that song is very touchy, though, and I really feel it, and you all tell me, like, what y'all like about track 14, is that one of the emotional songs to close the record with? I just like that Jay-Z was telling his story with that track, and y'all just can't get enough of it. Let me know your thoughts. Because it is an interesting song to close the record with. That's all I can say, though. But y'all can tell me what y'all think of the track in the comments below. Well, that's a wrap, everybody. We just reviewed all 14 tracks on his second album by Jay-Z called Volume 1, In My Lifetime. This album is such a masterpiece. It debuted at number 3 on the charts, though. But it was number 2 for top R&B / hip-hop albums of 1997. It went 2 times platinum, selling like 100,000 copies, and it went silver in United Kingdom. And it has like 3 dope singles off the album, such as Who You With, Always Be My Sunshine, The City Is Mine. And I really like the collaborations, I really like the guest appearances that he had on here from like P. Diddy, Lil' Kim, Too Short, Sauce Money, and among more. And you all can tell me, like, we gotta rate this out one of Jay-Z's best albums of 1997, or one of his worst, cause me, I rate this is one of the dopest albums that came out in 1997 when he was beginning his career after the success of his first album, Reasonable Doubt. And I gotta say, all the tracks on this album are dope. I don't have specific tracks, but I give this album 100 stars. And Jay-Z is still a dope legend to this day and a dope MC. And he is a true lyricist. And I really feel all the rhymes and the stories that he was telling with every track on this album. And I give it 100 stars. And you all can tell me, like, what's your favorite track? And do you rate this as one of Jay-Z's best or worst albums that he done in his younger days to begin his career as a successful rapper? Let me know. Well, this is your boy Jay Bird, aka Mr. Cool Guy. That was my album review by Jay-Z reviewing his second album that came out when it was the year 1997 called Volume 1, In My Lifetime. Feel free to hit that subscribe button, tune to my later videos, give me a thumbs up if you like this video, and let me know what's your favorite track off of that album by Jay-Z in the comments below. And peace out, y'all be cool, y'all take it easy, and I'll see y'all next time. Deuces, y'all.